ready, go.
Hi, I don't tap, and this is how to architect.
This is the fourth video in a five-part series called Could You Be an Architect? In the last three videos, I said that there are four simple questions you should answer if you're thinking about architecture as a profession. The fourth question is, are you creative? That is, are you inventive, imaginative, and good at coming up with ideas in your mind? By the time you're ready for college, you should already have an idea as to whether or not you're good at this. However, contrary to popular thought, being creative is not the same thing as being a good designer. Design involves problem solving, and that is something you learn more about in higher education. When it comes to architecture, problem solving is about taking an idea and turning it into something real, like a building. Problem solving involves working through every aspect of a particular challenge through research, sketching, drawing, model making, and other modes of expression. Problem solving will generate even more ideas that one will eventually coalesce into a real thing, and that's design. You should come to school being somewhat creative, but you don't have to be proficient at design. All that said, the reality is that architects are not creative all day long. In fact, what they really do is a lot of problem solving. Among many tasks, the architect is asked to design a better detail, fix this contract, make the bathroom work, find a better material, talk to the contractor, settle this dispute, make changes to drawings and specifications, etc. In fact, the job of an architect can be like many other professions. Long hours, lots of stress, headaches that don't seem to go away, and long stretches of monotonous work. So, being creative is one part of the education and job of an architect, but when the rubber meets the road, it's about a lot more. See you for part 5.